You look for it and find me fooling with some other gal. Then you rave, yes you crave, to see you dead and in grave. So if your man is nice, take my advice and hug him in the morning.
Kiss him every evening.
Give him plenty love and treat him right. For a good man nowadays is hard to find.
There's her
letter! Miss Lamore! Miss Lamore!
Miss Lipton! I want to personally welcome you to the Hotel Cara.
I am Russell Brouquet, the hotel concierge.
At your service.
Where is she? Where is she? Oh, I am going to mess this up. I can just feel it. Remember the date, September 6th, 1962. The date Chickie Lipton messed it all up. Do you have any idea how hard it is to get Lillian Lamore out of retirement? Do you?
Calm down, Miss Lipton.
Oh, I am calm.
You're eating the popari?
My dad was the most successful publicist in all of Hollywood. He was the one who told Lucille Ball to dye it red. And now, after he talks Lillian Lamore out of retirement, he gets the flu. So here I am. It's all up to me. Her costumes. Where are her costumes?
Calm down.
Oh, calming down. Woo. Normally, I am a very relaxed person.
Yes, yes.
No.
What?
This is the dress from No Man Can Tame Her, where she plays the sexy lion tamer. I will never forget that song. A good man is hard to find.
You always get it. Oh,
why does she have so many of the same dress?
No one has seen her since 1947. We're not sure what size she'll be. Miss Lipton. Where do you want this, suitcase? Right there. Oh, this place is swarming with people trying to catch a glimpse of Lillian Lamore.
I'll get security.
Oh, I smell like a zoo.
Did you get the lion?
Yup,
a retired circus lion named Tumba. Beautiful. You want to tell me why I snuck a lion in here? Miss Lamore is famous for this photo. So, I'm gonna reshoot it before we leave for the theater.
Knock, knock. Is that gonna be again?
Oh, Rita! Oh no, don't tell me she's canceled.
She didn't cancel.
So, are you excited for tonight?
Who wouldn't be? My mother's big comeback. But you got me a date with Troy Donahue! Whoa!
You never asked him?
I knew it! It's not easy being the daughter of a sex symbol.
I'm a woman. A woman with needs.
I know what I need. I need to tell you something.
Not now.
Oh, there's gotta be someone in New York City that's willing to date me.
Oh, Rita.
Tuma's gone.
Oh,
Tuma, the lion. Oh, if they find him, they'll know I snuck him in here and I'll lose my job.
And I will lose my photo op.
Oh, I've got a pain shooting up my arm. It's a blood clot.
It's not a blood clot. Let's just breathe.
Why did this have to happen to me?
Maybe it's the lion. Lions can't knock.
They don't have knuckles.
For a good man, nowadays is hard.
can't believe it's really you.
Oh, it's real, honey.
It's all real.
Lillian, you look great.
You were a goddess 20 years ago, and you're a goddess now.
Would somebody tip this guy?
Miss Lamour, if you need anything at all, do not hesitate to call.
Oh, I should have never said yes to this. You have no idea what it's like to be an old woman in show business.
Age doesn't matter. You are Lillian Lamour. Remember.
The one and only.
We gotta find that lion!
No, I might have it.
I've even got ringing in my ears.
It's the phone.
Hello? Look, Johnny, I gave Miss Lamour your messages. She doesn't want to talk to you. You know what they say. If you love something, set it free.
Please.
And after 15 years, if they still don't return your calls, well, then that must mean you stink.
Who was that?
Johnny Toronado.
The singer?
The hashtag.
Watch out, everyone. A legend is coming through.
Johnny called again.
Oh, Johnny. Be nice to him. I broke his heart.
Lillian, we are a little pressed for time.
Let me get my makeup.
Oh, why do you even need makeup?
Honey, at my age, I'm better off using spackling house paint.
Do you understand? Whoa! I command you to stop! No, please, you don't understand.
I was born.
But what about Rita?
What about Rita?
Your daughter!
She's adopted.
Oh! Put that back on! Well, you look just like a man.
No, please, please don't tell anyone. I swore I'd take this to my grave.
Oh, you are taking it to your grave, all right? Those things are attached.
I spent a lifetime creating Lillian L'Amour. I was gonna die a legend, and now I'm just gonna die a freak.
No, do not cry, just. Could you please put your wig back on?
I started out in vaudeville as Hank Podell and his wonder dog fella, and we were terrible.
Is this gonna take a while? Because I think I'm gonna vomit.
One night, I overheard an agent looking for a female singer. So I did what any out-of-work actor would have done. I ran out, stole some clothes, and returned as
Lillian L'Amour.
And everyone loved me. And now I'm ruined!
We're all ruined! The doctor is on his way! He's gonna see that you're not a Lillian! The doctor doesn't know who got bit. He can fix you up without knowing you're Lillian. Then you can go back to being her.
Yes, yes, and all those years, men were dreaming about grabbing these.
The doctor is on his way. We have never had a ordinary day in this hotel.
Now, who exactly was bitten by that?
You know what?
Well, if you must. No, it was Patty. Oh, Nixon.
Who?
Patty O'Nixon is Miss L'Amour's lover.
Patty O'Nixon is my lover?
Yeah.
From Ireland.
Ireland!
Is that so? Well, where is he?
Well, after he got bit, he went to go lie down. Why don't you go get him, Lillian?
I'd love to, but he's in the bathtub.
Bathtub?
Yes, naked as a jaybird, without any clothes to put on.
Yes, I think I can help you there.
We'll be right back.
Good God! Were you bit too?
Not at all!
I see blood! Two rat bites? Oh!
I sure hope the press doesn't get a hold of this. Lillian L'Amour and Leather attacked by giant rats in swanky hotel.
Could we just keep this between us?
Of course! I'm great at keeping secrets.
Mum's the word!
Miss Moore! Biggest fan!
Doctor, it seems that Miss L'Amour and her boyfriend have somehow been bitten by a wandering rat! We must be very discreet. Have you looked?
Now then, Miss L'Amour, let's take a look at this nasty little bite. Shall we?
Doctors make me nervous.
Then don't think of me as a doctor. After all, I'm just a man underneath.
Hey, aren't we all?
So, where'd you get bit?
My ear.
Oh, she was bitten on the...
Just to give you a quick shot. Good as new. You're a man. I'm gonna tell the world that Lillian L'Amour is a man.
No, wait, please!
Not so fast, dog!
Do something!
What'd you do that for?
I panicked! Keep moving it! Oh, jeez, he is a fat one!
What a pig!
Grab his pants!
What?
His pants!
Oh, okay. Lillian!
Johnny!
Johnny Toronado.
What are y'all doing here?
I want to see Lillian.
She doesn't want to talk to you. It's been 15 years. Take a hint.
Where is she?
Lillian! If you can hear me, would you come out here for a minute? Please!
Yeah? Who are you?
This is Patty O'Nixon, Miss Lamour's lover.
From Ireland!
That's right, Lasse!
Well, I'm Johnny Toronado.
Lillian's spoken of you often.
Did she tell you she...
She broke my heart.
She cared for you.
She cared for you very much, Johnny. But she...
But you got it, right? I'd have bopped you right in the face, you potato-eating batso. Where is she?
I'll go get her.
You're going nowhere. You go get her.
Me?
Yeah, you.
I'll get her. Lillian! Are you in there? Help! It's trying to kill me!
An animal one doesn't normally see in a four-star hotel?
Yes, yes. Oh, quick! Show me where it went.
Be careful, Lasse. It's a jungle out there.
Who are you?
That's your mother's Irish boyfriend, Patty O'Nixon.
My mother's what?
Guinness guzzling moron.
Who are you?
That's your mother's ex-boyfriend.
Lillian!
Hello, Johnny.
Lillian, you have no idea what it's been like. You have no idea what it's been like since you jilted me. Baby, you were my muse.
Well, no muse is good muse.
Lillian, I'm not gonna give up for the fight. You haven't heard the last of Johnny Toronado. Cause Pussycat, we're a team. A team.
I am sorry, Johnny.
I am just not myself right now.
Oh, sitting by the window with the moonlight on your face. Oh,
poor Johnny.
Oh, I've got a Charlie horse in my neck. Oh, my leg. My leg. I think I'm gonna. The show's in 20 minutes. Come on, let's get you into a dress.
Where? You dirty rodente! Oh, what? Hump! Oh, what? Where?
Come to my hotel, will you?
Ah, there you are.
Oh, Dr. Dubell!
Don't let them find you.
Where are your pants?
They stole my pants! Who? A man!
A man stole your pants.
No! She's a man! Hi!
Dr. Dubell? Dr. Dubell!
Delia! That's not your friend!
Oh, get away from me!
Good God, man! Have you lost your mind?
You are a liar, William Lamour! I saw it with a lion in mind.
The what?
The lion.
A lion. We need to get you sober now.
What? No. She's a hate.
Let's go, Doc.
Let them get dressed.
Oh, it's over, Chicky. Rita has to hear it from me that I am a man.
So tell her.
Oh, Rita, sit down, honey. There's something I need to tell ya.
Joey already told me who you were.
Do you hate me?
Why would I hate you? I've always wanted a father. Now we'll have both.
Oh, dearie.
Can you believe that your mother didn't think you'd love her if you knew she was a man?
What?
Where's my mother?
Right here, Rita.
Get away from me!
No, wait, please, honey.
No, wait, honey, I can explain. Rita!
Rita!
that, wouldn't you? Get out of my way, you beer drinking bar trot!
Don't panic, but there's a lion in the hotel!
Oh, quick! Hide the Christians!
She's so young that she's a yes. It's in there with Lillian.
Shaggy!
You called.
Where have you been?
Nothing! Why, did I miss something?
Where is Lillian?
Try the urinal. Lillian the Moor is dead.
Dead? She can't be dead. I have a theater full of people waiting to see her.
Well, too bad. She's gone forever. May God rest her soul.
I don't believe this.
Lillian! Oh, what happened in there, Patty?
Well, as we tried to make a ring for the door, the vicious booster pounced on me poor Lillian and knocked her to the ground. And as he rolled her across the floor, as if she was nothing but a wee rattle, she cried out, "The weight of the lion is killing me, Patty.
No!
The weight of the lion is killing me, Patty." And I screamed, "Hold on, Lillian, I'm coming." And she cried out, "No, Patty, it's too late. The lion is crushing the life out of me. I can't live like this anymore. It's the final curtain for Miss L'Amour."
And you just stood there?
No. But it was too late. Lillian L'Amour is gone for good.
Hold on. I see what you're trying to do here. You're trying to cover it up so the world doesn't find out that Lillian L'Amour's a man. Where is he? Where? Lillian!
Who is to call the police?
No! No one needs to know that Lillian is dead.
What?
All we have to do is send someone dressed as Lillian to Carnegie Hall. We'll introduce her. She'll bow and then get off stage. And no one will need to know that she died at the Carlisle Hotel.
It just might work.
You sicko! You can't just pretend that death never happened.
Johnny, I am only doing this for Lillian.
For her reputation, her image.
Her legacy.
Wait.
We do not want the golden image of Lillian L'Amour tarnished by this freakish death.
You're right.
The world will remember Lillian the way she wanted to be remembered. For Lillian.
To Carnegie Hall.
Yeah.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Carnegie Hall. Tonight, we are proud to present to you once in a lifetime encore performance from the one, the only, the lovely Lillian L'Amour. But first, Carnegie Hall's own Lady Lion Chamber.
Whoa.